Thank you for attending this briefing. As the chief medical officer for England, I must warn you of an alarming new development, a threat that is present right here and now, which, if left unchecked, could pose the greatest risk to the health service since the pandemic began.
Hello, I'm Dido Harding. And I'm applying to be the chief executive of NHS England.
May God help us all.
Dead ringers.
Hello and welcome to Today with Martha Carney and Nick Robinson.
The headlines. After President Macron was slapped during a visit to the Rhone, French police immediately seized two men and led them away to be congratulated. Officials fear Joe Biden has set himself two impossible goals for the G7 summit in Cornwall, seeing agreement on carbon neutrality by 2025 and getting a table for four without booking at Rick Stein's restaurant in Padstow.
After the G7 event, Biden is due to meet Vladimir Putin. He's expected to offer Putin an olive branch. And Putin is expected to offer the president a cup of coffee that's starting to melt the spoon.
The EU and the UK remain locked in negotiations over the Northern Ireland Protocol. Back from Portugal, Michael Gove joins us now.
Lovely to be here, Martha. They tried to make Govey go to quarantine. I said, Novi, no, no.
It seems the UK is furious with the EU for wanting to implement the exact protocol which we agreed to.
Well, absolutely, Martha. I am incandescent. How dare they assume we were acting in good faith when we signed it? Haven't they met me?
The government this week faced a Tory backbench revolt over cuts to the overseas aid budget. Laura Koonsberg joins us now from Westminster.
That's right, Nick. Leading the Tory rebels was former Prime Minister Theresa May.
We have to help people with no hope, and I should know. I lost all hope long ago. Did you know I spent all yesterday eating my Müller Light yogurts without using the fruit corners just to remind myself what being me felt like?
Boris Johnson, however, was having none of it.
What? What a load of piffle! By not spending these billions on poor kids in far-off Bongo Land, we can instead not spend that money improving the lives of poor children here! More bloody ankle biters wanting Boris's money, not without a DNA test, matey!
Just a few weeks ago, of course, the Prime Minister was married at Westminster Cathedral. The BBC obtained this exclusive footage.
Do you, Alexander Boris de Pfeffel, take this woman to bury any bad news about the Downing Street refurb, Tory chums being awarded PPE contracts by the shedload, and Matt Hancock's latest screw-up, as long as you both shall live in number 10?
Quoi, I do.
And do you, Carrie Lady Macbeth Simmons, take this man to rub Dominic Cummings' nose in it that you won your epic Downing Street power battle and emerged triumphant as the sole power behind the throne?
I do.
I now pronounce you man and wife. Boris, you may kiss that bridesmaid you've been eyeing up all afternoon.
Many Westminster observers were surprised by Keir Starmer's appearance on Piers Morgan's Life Stories.
I jumped at the chance. It was so amazing to spend an hour sitting across from someone who is actually less popular than me.
Dido Harding believes she has widespread public support for becoming head of the NHS because she hasn't been able to track down a single person who thinks it's a bad idea.
Billionaire Jeff Bezos has announced that next month he'll be taking his first trip into space. He'll be stuck in a metal box for days on end and peeing into a tube, just like his Amazon employees.
As Portugal was moved from the green to the amber travel list, the government denied its traffic light system was in disarray. Transport Secretary and door-to-door duster salesman Grant Shapps joins us now.
There's nothing confusing about our traffic light system, Nick. If a country is on the green list, you can travel there knowing you shouldn't. If a country is on the amber list, you can, should not, are allowed to travel there whilst not. And if a country is on the red list, the only two exemptions allowing travel are compassionate leave due to a bereavement or being Boris Johnson's dad.
Where are we? What
Connor?
Marianne?
Connor?
Marianne?
I've been thinking.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Go on.
It's just...
What?
Just, you know how you won a BAFTA for your performance as a moody, monosyllabic, horny teenager in Normal People?
That I did.
Right, you did.
I did so.
So?
So?
It's just...
Go on.
Why didn't I win a BAFTA for my identical performance as a moody, monosyllabic, horny teenager in Normal People?
That's a good point, so.
Right.
Right. Maybe you weren't horny enough.
Right. Maybe.
Marianne.
Connor.
Want to prove BAFTA wrong?
I might as well.
Howdy all, this is Joe Biden here sending out this message to all of my friends in the UK. I am loving being here in the Cornwall. Interesting fact for all you Cornwallians. We have scones in the US too, but we call them hot dogs. Top of my agenda is sorting out the Northern Ireland border of the United Kingdom. The UK and the EU need to sit down and settle the dispute the old-fashioned way. Like my pappy and his Uncle Clem. They were always scrapping, so they decided to settle their differences with an old-fashioned horse wrestling contest. Though we called horses gators back then. My pappy won, then Uncle Clem shot him. Then pappy's wife grabbed the gun and shot Uncle Clem, and the whole town caught bison fever and died. All sorted. I hope that's a guide for how Michael Gove and Ursula von der Leyen can sort out those problems with his sausages. Or as we call them in the US, Twinkies.
Welcome back to Naked Attraction, a Dulux paint chart of ball bags. Before the break, our contestants selected the Red Pod, so let's find out who's inside. Red Pod, tell us a bit about yourself.
Hello, I'm Keir, I'm from London, and I work in politics.
And why have you come on, Keir?
I want to show more of myself to people. And after my reveal-all interview with Piers Morgan resulted in a whopping 1% poll increase, I'm hoping that exposing my junk on national television could get me to within 20 points of the Tories. And besides, letting everyone see my Ramsay MacDonald is a lot easier than coming up with a whole policy platform. So get a good look, everyone. You'll be seeing more of me through your letterbox.
It's Sunday night here on BBC One, and in a twist worthy of Line of Duty, it's an extra episode of Line of Duty.
Sir, why have you called us back here?
Because Jesus, Mary, Joseph and the wee donkey and the donkey's pet gerbil. The whole thing stinks. It stinks to high heaven.
The institutionalised corruption in the police force, sir. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.